I am Monica Macovei, a member of the European Parliament. I was in Romania before Romania's accession to the European Union, the Minister of Justice, and I set up the Anti-Corruption Prosecutor's Office to fight against high-level political corruption, judicial corruption, fraud, for instance, money laundering over 1 million euros, and serious crimes. Since then, we had ministers, former prime minister, tens of deputies, tens of mayors, many high-level officials from the administration, from the judiciary system, convicted, finally convicted, in prison. And only last year we had 900 convictions of high-level officials. I would say the opposition of the politicians, because when you fight political corruption, of course the corrupt politicians will oppose. And also the reform of the judiciary, because any reform of a professional system is a challenge. People don't like to reform, they don't like new laws, they don't like new practices, they don't like to change their networks. But I wanted very much the real reform and the real anti-corruption fight against corruption in Romania. And therefore, nothing was difficult because I had this objective. I took any risk, and if you want to do something big for your country, you take any risk. And also, you have to predict any possible obstacle and to have solutions before the obstacle comes. And this way, you go smoothly and you reach your objective, and which I did in less than 2 years. I recommend to the Ukrainian politicians the following steps. Cleaning the judiciary, that's a first step, because if the judiciary is clean, then the judiciary will clean all the other system, political system or other systems. Now, to clean the judiciary, you need to test the judiciary. Not everyone can be a judge or a prosecutor. They need to be tested for honesty, integrity, for strength, for resistance to political pressure. Another measure I recommend is confiscation, extended confiscation, which is more than the object of the crime. The difference between the legal income and what a person has in reality under his or her control, not necessarily under his name, because people move their assets and their houses and lands and money on wives, children, friends, relatives. Also, I recommend merging between the NABU and the Anti-Corruption Directorate in the General Prosecutor Office. It's good to work together, prosecutors and investigators and detectives, and to have also interceptions and all surveillance measures at their disposal, and to be the only one who do it. Another measure, severe sanction to conflict of interest and incompatibilities. Public support for reforms come from final convictions. When people see that it's real, that high-level officials, politicians from power, from opposition, from administration are in prison and their assets are confiscated, then they believe and then they support the institution. You will never get political consensus. You need a majority at some point. When you have a majority, it's good to use it to take advantage and to pass the laws which you need. There is no absolute consensus for this. It's always opposition and power.